I'm at Green Park. Hello. Gotta jump on the Piccadilly line. Got some explaining to do. Is that bright sun? Is that making me a halo? I suspect so. Let's get down the low. So here's the deal. The other day I made a video where I was at Tufnell Park and I climbed up the staircase and I put a caption on saying that it was the equivalent to a 15-story building. Some of you, quite rightly, in the comments said, "But the number of steps that I said, that's not a 15-storey building." And it's kind of my fault for not explaining the joke, so I need to explain the joke, but I also need to go to the source of that joke, the original 15-storey building, which is Covent Garden. Covent Garden is a classic case of a 1906 Leslie Green station, which has lifts and a spiral staircase. And technically, the spiral staircase is only meant to be used in an emergency. Now this is the spiral staircase, and it is quite clearly a sign that says the 193 stairs is equivalent to 15 floors. It's here again, with a really nice to the train sign. There are 193 steps to climb, equivalent to a 15-story building. Again, this station is 15 floors below ground. I'm gonna walk the 193 steps and we'll talk about my theory at the top. Covent Garden, 193 steps, claims to be a 15-storey or 15-floor building. By the way, there's a story as to why it's called storey. Apparently, historically, in some places that had steps, they used to put storeys, S-T-O-R-I-E-S, on every floor, which then became every storey, so that as people climbed the steps, they could read stories. That might be an urban legend. 193 steps at Covent Garden, that bit is correct. I've counted it. Don't get me started on London Underground stations, which have incorrect signage for how many steps they have. Save that for another video. So, on the way up, I brought my tape measure, obviously. Why wouldn't you bring your tape measure? And I measured some of the steps here at Covent Garden, 17 centimetres. You can see where this is going, can't you? This is going to be a mass thing. Now, if you Google around online, look at architect websites, they tell you that a storey or one floor is typically 10 feet. Imperial measurements, we'll scrap that, we'll do the maths. That is 304, just over 3 metres, 304 centimetres per floor or per storey. We'll do the maths completely once I've taken you to somewhere else on the network. This way. Square, but there's 175 steps. Let's do these. So I'm walking up 175 steps of Russell Square, where again I've measured, and the depth of the step is 17 centimetres. Okay.
Russell Square.
It's a great Leslie Green station, by the way, amongst all the tiles and the nice semicircular arches there. Note how the top floor, look, they always used to leave space on top of the building for them to be built on, but here at Russell Square is one that they never built on. Little gem there from my knowledge tube bank of underground history. Great white van blocking the shot. Thanks, white van. The point is, I measured the steps again. They're 17 centimetres. There are 175 of them here at Russell Square. Now, it doesn't say it anymore, but I have photographic evidence. Here is the photo on the screen now. It wasn't so long ago that there used to be a sign here at Russell Square also saying that those 175 stairs are the equivalent of a 15-storey building. So Covent Garden, 193 stairs, saying it's 15 storeys. Russell Square, 175 stairs, also saying it's 15 storeys. I've got one more example I need to take you to. So I'm changing at Leicester Square from the Piccadilly line to the Northern line. That's handy. The train has just pulled in. I'll take that. Lovely.
This is a Northern line train terminating at Edgware.
Except here's the fun thing, as I actually went back onto the tube at Russell Square and I went down the spiral staircase, I got a shot on my phone. Here's a rough shot on my phone. There is still a sign up at the top of the stairs saying 175 steps is equivalent to a 15th floor building. So the sign is still there, but there's one more place here and a few more stops on the Northern Line, which is like the daddy of all steps and floor signage. Okay, so this is it, Hampstead. This is the deepest, windy, this is the deepest staircase on the network. 320 steps. And yes, there's the sign saying it's the equivalent to climbing a 15-storey building. Let's do it. Okay, Hampstead Tube, 320 steps, still says it's the equivalent of 15 floors. I measured the steps again, they're 17 centimetres. Something very wrong is going on here. So it's time to do some maths. Okay, so I've come home. That is a really yellow screen. Where are my scissors? I'll just have to tear it manually. It's dark. I couldn't find a cafe to sit in. I've come home this evening. I just thought I'd do the maths part when I get back here home this evening, except it's now dark outside. I can't wait for someone to be here. Light will come in the window. It then won't look so yellow. And basically, I just need to do some quick maths to demonstrate what's going on. The thing is, this whole... So the joke is that TfL clearly just put up signs saying that all tube stations have 15 floors or 15 stories, no matter if they're 15 stories or not. And I incorporated that into my stand-up comedy show about the tube called Tube Spotting.
This thing is like, because the Covent Garden steps to me are so infamous, that this is like the standard marker. If we go to the deepest tube station on the network, which is Hampstead, with 320 steps, how many floors is that? Yeah, it's also 15, you see, right? And I'm like, hang on a second, you just said TfL, but that's like, that's 15, how can that also be 15? They probably just made a mistake, it's fine. Which is interesting, because then I got to Russell Square the next day.
And so the gag is that TfL just go, yeah, we'll just put 15 floors. No matter how many steps it has, that's the gag. But I wanted to do the actual math. So there's two quick things to do here. So we'll do Covent Garden, Russell Square, and Hampstead. So these are our three stations, that will do. Now, so what we know is that Covent Garden is 193 steps, Russell Square is 175, and Hampstead is 320. Now, if you divide, if we take Covent Garden as like the marker, because I remember seeing, to me, Covent Garden has always been like, you know, like the base. That's what's the word where you take something as like the control. That's the word I'm thinking of. That's our control in this experiment. We're going to take Covent Garden as red. Let's say that really is 15 floors, which it isn't, which we'll get to in a minute. But that would mean 193 divided by 15 gives you 12.8. So if you then divide, if you then divide the 175 of Russell Square by 12.8, you get actually 13.6, but we'll round it down. So in Russell Square, in Covent Garden measurement, Russell Square should be really 13 floors. And then, bizarrely, Hampstead, if you divide 320 by 12.8, if there are any maths people out there, you will love this, it is a perfect 25, no remainder. So 320 divided by 12.8 equals 25. So those I've done that in pink, you can't see that, can you? When I do the next batch in a second, I won't do it in pink. It's 15, 13.6 and 25. However, as mentioned earlier, I'll do it in green this time. So again, this time, as I think I mentioned earlier in the video, architects' designs say that a floor story is 10 feet, 12 inches and a foot. I think it's 30.4 centimetres in 12 inches a foot. That means that one floor is 300 centimetres. Is that right? Yes. I think that's right. My math works out, trust me. If you then do, so then it's important, that's why I measured it, the 17. If you do 17 centimetres, which is the depth of a step, multiplied by 193 at Covent Garden, that gives you, I hope this is right, because you're going to so tell me if it's wrong, 3,281 centimetres divided by 304. So actually, Covent Garden is 10.7 floors high. You could round that up to 11. If my math is wrong, you're gonna cane me in the comments. That's fine. Applying the same math, 17 centimeters times the 175 steps at Russell Square, I think comes out at 2,975 centimeters divided by 304 gives you 9.7, which will round up to 10. So Russell Square is really just under 10 floors, a 10-story building. And then finally, just to do Hampstead, it's 17 centimetres times 320, comes to 5,440 centimetres divided by 304, a grand total of 17.8, which I'll round up to 18. It's an 18-floor storey building. That is my maths. If you think I've done it wrong, I'm sure you will tell me. TFL, if you're watching, please don't ever change your posters. They make me laugh. Do more. Go to Chalk Farm, where there's only 54 steps, and put up a sign there saying, this is the equivalent of a 15-storey building. Let's make this a running gag. All tube stations, forevermore, should always be 15 floors deep underground. Right? Thanks.